All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is John Dwyer. He is the CEO of Gamelancer Media Corp. And John, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Thank you for having me.
Excited to talk a little bit about where the company's at and where you're going, and more importantly, a bit more about the company and sort of something that the public doesn't always see, and that's the content creation and why that's so important for a company like Gamelancer. And maybe you could talk about the world that you play in and how content really is king.
Yeah, it certainly is. You know, we're undergoing a fascinating paradigm shift over the past 5 years that not nearly enough people are talking about. The advent of social media and creator platforms like Facebook, for instance, and their ability to sell advertising was based on their ability to mine data. Facebook and Instagram in particular have known everything about us since the advent of the platform and all of us signing up and willingly handing over all of our sovereign information. And so until 2019, there was a legislative change that stopped the way these platforms are allowed to mine data. For instance, if you're a female who's 9 months pregnant and you go onto Google and you type in Pampers diapers that are for sensitive skin, Facebook is going to buy that data, or it did previously, from Google, and now it's going to show you a still image of a sale on Pampers ads. And so they have so much data, they know how to convert their followers. 2019, we saw legislative changes happen across many regions, not least of which here in North America, which have diminished these platforms' ability to mine data. So what does that mean? They don't know what you want anymore. So now we're back in the business of creative. We're back in the business of actually compelling people to buy something by virtue of the fact that they're seeing creative on a screen and it's converting them, right? And so that's a really unique phenomenon that's not happened since the era of, you know, the madman, Madison Avenue, this whole concept that you were compelling people to do something. So this big seismic change, this shift that we've seen happen, TikTok has risen to the top. And many reasons, because it's all about creative. So advertising online, whether you're talking about social media platforms, creator platforms, or just on the internet, because we cannot mine data the way that we used to, we're back to the world of creative, and that's what we do. And that's why we're growing so quickly.
Yeah. And what's interesting about it, people say, well, how do you get people to sort of watch the content and then try and get them to go out and do a purchase or something like that? But what I found interesting was people that are on your site or engaging in what you're doing on TikTok, averaging about 95 minutes a day. That's a lot of content that someone's viewing every day.
You know, we're populating anywhere around 120 to 150 videos a day across 44 channels on TikTok, Instagram, and Snap. So if you're a young person from the age of 12 to 26, you're in that Gen Z demographic. It's now 13 to 27 as they're naturally getting older. Millennials are now into their early 40s. These are people that are typically not native television watchers, right? So if you said to somebody, hey, do you watch an hour and a half of TV every day? They'd say, yeah, that's fairly healthy. If you said to somebody, do you spend an hour and a half on TikTok every day? They seem to think that's peculiar. But if you look at it through the lens of TikTok is replacing TV. Linear broadcast television is not interactive. You're forced to watch commercials you don't want to watch. Whereas TikTok, it's on an infinite scroll. You don't like it, just scroll, right? And so that's the functionality that's happening. You drop away all of the geopolitical issues around China. You put that to sleep over the next 6 to 9 to 12 months. You're going to see this evolve into a cash-making machine. And that's what TikTok is at its underpinning. It's a platform built to monetize creative.
So as I mentioned, you've got about 38 million followers that are going on there, and a lot of that is obviously TikTok. And I'm wondering, how do you create, you're getting a lot of eyeballs on your company. How did you create, or how did you get those Madison Avenue bigwigs to kind of take a look and say, here's a company that's doing, you know, they put out guidance that's going to be successful this year. They got all these followers and they work with some really major brands. Is that when people start noticing you, is when you start to take a leader position in the market?
You know, that's a great question. And it was the opposite of that. I mean, we had brands like Samsung, who took a big bet with us at the beginning of last year. We did nationwide the Samsung Odyssey campaign for their Samsung Odyssey is a 32-inch video game monitor. It's the curved monitor. It's spectacular for gaming and all things watching TV, et cetera. And so this product was up 41% year over year in Q1 last year. We won business by performing. We got in the door and we under-promised and over-delivered. We said, give us an opportunity. Give us a $25,000 campaign. Now we'll do millions with Samsung Canada. We'll do millions with Samsung US each year. And it's continuing to grow. But it all starts with performance. And so just like in any other realm in media, you have to demonstrate you own an audience and you have creative that performs for your audience. If you can do that, now the brands will understand that you can convert. You can turn your audience into consumers. That's our whole game.
Okay. And lastly, John, does that put more pressure on you to create better and more unique content now because you have so many followers who are following you all the time and these brands are saying, well, you're getting return on that, but we have to keep upping the content. Is that something you really stress with your team?
Yeah, upping the content is normally something that's dictated by the audience, funny enough. You know, when people are watching on TikTok, on Instagram, or on Snapchat, it's not a passive experience. You can like, comment, share, and bookmark. If you don't like something, you're going to say it really quick, slide into the comments. Typically, your name is a pseudonym of some sort, so you're really interacting in a way anonymously. So we have to consistently make sure that the content that's being populated on our channels is not only in keeping with what our audience wants, you know, today and yesterday, but with those trends as they change. TikTok has an algorithm that serves you content based on trends. It's businesses like ours that serve content that informs how that algorithm is rewarding videos. But at the same time, we have to make sure that we are up to the newest trends and in many ways driving those new trends.
Absolutely. Well, John, I know that people in the capital markets are paying attention. And that's always a good thing. So good to talk to you as well. Have a great day.
Thank you, sir.
John Dwyer, the CEO of Gamelancer Media Corp.